greatness. What is greatness? There was a man in Russia who was the great king. He was called Peter the Great. He's the one that westernized Russia. Was he really great? There was a Macedonian general, one of the smartest generals they say has ever lived. His name was Alexander, and he was known as Alexander the Great. Yet he drank himself to death when he was maybe 31 or 2 years old. Was he great? We had a boxer named Muhammad Ali, Cassius Clay, who said, "I float like a butterfly, I sting like a bee. I'm the greatest." Was Muhammad Ali, who now has Parkinson's disease, was he the greatest? Was he really, were these men really great? They like to think of themselves as great. Napoleon, the great. They weren't great. There's only one person who's ever really been great, and his name is Jesus. And he told us the secret of greatness. His disciples were arguing among themselves as to who was the greatest. You know, they were fighting. They say, what if you had a couple of kids squabbling about who was the best basketball player, whether it was LeBron James or Michael Jordan, and they were fighting each other over who was the greatest? Well, his disciples were fighting among who was the greatest. And he took a child and he set him in the midst and said, "You see this little child? He that becomes like a little child, he'll be great in the kingdom." What is it about a little child that makes him great? I'll tell you, the thing about a child that is so interesting is that his ears are always open. He's always asking questions. He has an inquiring mind. Why is the grass green, Daddy? Why is the sun up, Daddy? What happened to the moon, Daddy? What about the stars, Daddy? Why do those dogs walk that way instead of the other way, Daddy? And they just keep asking. They say that a child between the age of 4 and 5 will learn more than an older child will learn during 4 years of college. Their minds are open to listen. And the other thing is about a child is they're trusting. A child has to rely on his mother and father to feed him, clothe him, house him. They just take it for granted that mommy and daddy are going to take care of me. You'd hate to have a child always worried about whether he's going to get the next meal. Now, there's some in the third world that are that way, but certainly here in America, in the average family, children rely on their parents. Certainly a little baby does. A baby doesn't sit around having discussions with his fellows. "You reckon our folks are going to feed us today?" I mean, he just yells and he gets a bottle. You know how it is. They expect it because they're trusting. And that's what God says, "I want those who are trusting in me, who will rely on me as the source of their blessing." Now, Jesus also expanded on this concept of greatness. He said, "The kings of this earth exalt themselves, and men call them benefactors." They exalt themselves for greatness. But he said, it's not supposed to be that way with you. "He that is the least among you, let him be the greatest of all. He that is the slave of others." He said, "I am the Son of God, yet I'm with you as one that serves." And you recall those days before he's crucified, when they were in the upper room and he took a basin and he knelt down and he began to wash the feet of his disciples. And he says, "If I'm your master and Lord, you see what I'm doing, you should wash the feet of your other disciples. I am taking the role of a slave. He that is the greatest is the bond slave of all." Now, that sounds kind of crazy. Most people don't want to be servants. They don't want to be servants. Who wants to be in the role of a servant? You know, a lot of folks, certainly 100 years ago, our African-American friends were pretty much consigned to menial tasks in the kitchen. So they don't want that, and I don't blame them. They want to get educated. They want to sit in the executive suite. They want to be CEOs and leaders and generals, and they are. But when are you really great? You're great when you are a servant. Now, you and I don't want to be servants, do we? Well, think of the greatest inventor. Who would you say is the greatest inventor? Well, you'd say Thomas Edison probably is the greatest inventor. Why is he great? He's great because he served the most people. You'd think about Henry Ford. He was a great industrialist. He had his flaws, but he was a great industrialist. Why? Because he served people with cheap transportation. And the more people he served, the greater he was. So also, public servants who honestly feel that their job it is to serve the public. If we want to be great, and I tell you, if the church wants to show itself strong in a sinful world, the best way we can do it is to serve the poor and the needy. If we go out and take the role of a servant, and we serve others. Now, business schools, you know, are teaching that, what they call servant leadership. That is one of the problems with American automobile manufacturers, is the guys in the front office, the big shots, wouldn't listen to the workers. They knew it all. I mean, they were the pros. They were the experts. Don't tell me how to run an automobile company. I've been here for 30 years. Well, it was tragic, wasn't it? General Motors went bankrupt, and we've lost our place among the nations and among the industrial titans of the world because our leaders wouldn't listen. They wouldn't listen. They were too proud. And along with this comes humility, because a child is humble. A little child is humble. And the Lord said, except you humble yourself and become like a little child, you cannot enter the kingdom of God. There's something about being humble and listening to somebody else. Teach me. The really smart people, the ones who really are the leaders in industry, the ones who are always learning and always saying, teach me. Are there any new techniques? Tell me. How do you do it? How do they do it? Tell me the new way. How does it go? And the ones who are ossified and say, oh, no, no, we've always done it this way. They'll be extinct. But God is saying to us, if you want to be a leader, serve. And if you want to be the greatest, you be the bond slave of all. And you look back to Jesus. What did he do? He gave his life for everyone. He is the greatest who ever lived because he served more people. He served the generations yet to be born. He served his contemporaries. He served everybody. His death won a place to heaven for all of us. That's why he is the greatest, not some general, not some king, not some prize fighter, but Jesus Christ. And he told us how we can reach greatness, and there's no other way than to have a servant's heart.